Does your merchandise business use unit of measure to manage your purchasing and selling of inventory? Well, in that case, you should watch this video because I'm going to give you an overview of how to use it, what it is, and show you exactly how to activate unit of measure. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Now, you may well ask, what is unit of measure? Well, the unit, container, group, or denomination that you purchase and or sell your inventory in. In other words, it's the way you measure or count how many items of inventory you have and how many in a purchase or a sale. Examples of inventory unit of measure would be things like purchasing boxes of candy bars and then selling the individual bars, or purchasing crates of milk bottles and selling the individual bottles, and so on. Now, before you can use unit of measure, you have to activate this feature in the QuickBooks Preferences window. Before you do that, you have to decide if you're going to use a single unit of measure for your merchandise items or multiple units of measure. Now, in this video, the first video in the series of three regarding unit of measure, we're only going to activate single units of measure. So let's go ahead and do that now. From the main menu, we click Edit, Preferences. Now, the category of preferences, obviously, is items and inventory. Then we click Company Preferences, and down here where it says Unit of Measure, we click Enable. Now, in this video, we are only enabling single unit of measure. And then we click Finish. Of course, you have to click OK to make sure that you've saved your preferences. Now, let's actually apply it to an item of inventory. When you use single unit of measure, all it will do is add an abbreviated text to the name of the item in the reports and in the transaction documents that item shows up on, like invoices when you sell or checks when you buy. Let's add an item called C vitamin to our inventory list. Let's imagine we buy it for $1 and sell it for $5. We will use the same sales account and same cost of goods sold account that we used for all our other inventory in this little inventory video series. And the name of the unit of measure will be bottle, and the abbreviation will be BLT. Okay, so before we record transactions, let's go ahead and set it up. From the main menu, click List, Item List. Then in the bottom left, we click Item, New. And this will be an inventory part because we want to track the quantity. The name will be C vitamins. Now, the cost that we purchase it at is $1. The price we sell it for, $5. Use the same cost of goods sold account that we used to hold the cost when we sell, like we did with any other inventory. And with any other inventory in the series, the income from the sale goes into this account, sales. Now, we don't have to do anything else because QuickBooks will remember this. As far as unit of measure, we should click here and we click Add New. Now, we will choose Other if you don't see the unit of measure on the list, and then click Next. and the name is bottle, because we sell them in bottles, and the abbreviation will be capital BLT, or BT, actually BTL, and we finish. That's the only thing we need to put, the name of the unit and the abbreviation, if we're using single unit of measure. Then we click OK, and now you will see how it works, and it's very simple. Let's imagine on January 1 of 2019, we buy 20 bottles of C vitamin from Staples. Okay, and we imagine we pay them immediately. So we click banking, write a check, and we put the date January 1 of 2019. Long after our last transaction, we bought from Staples. Now, we know we have unpaid bills, so we ignore this and click write a check. Now, we will not put the money amount. As we learned, if we're paying for inventory items, we click items. And watch what happens when we choose C vitamins. Aha! The unit of measure abbreviation shows up on the right. And how many did we buy? We bought 20 bottles, so we changed the quantity to 20. So right now, the only thing that's apparent from activating single unit of measure is that we can see the abbreviation in the bottom right when we wrote the check. We click Save and Close, and now let's take a look at our most favorite inventory report, the inventory valuation detail. And when you open it up, it does not show a unit of measure for apples. It does not show a unit of measure for bananas. But if you look at this, if you look at C vitamins, it says 200, it says quantity 20. Quantity is 20. That means we have 20 bottles. And if we double click, we can see the abbreviation here, BTL. Now, you may notice that you did not see a column for unit of measure in the inventory report. So how can you see the unit of measure? Well, just like we learned, you can customize the report and add the UM column, which is the column for unit of measure. So right now we have 20, but we don't know what denomination it is. So we click Custom Report. And in the Display tab, we scroll down slowly until we get here, UM, Unit of Measure. Click to add the check mark, click OK. And now you can see bananas and apples do not have a unit of measure, but the C vitamin does have an abbreviated unit of measure, BTL, for bottle. Now, let's actually sell this. So, let's imagine on January 2 of 2019, we sell 10 bottles to Alan cash today. That means we make a sale receipt. From the main menu, we click Customers, Enter Sale Receipt. And we choose the customer, Alan. We put the date January 2nd. The item is C vitamins. And notice, BTL, the abbreviation, shows up on the sale receipt just like it showed up on the check. And we're selling 10 of them, so the quantity is 10. And of course, QuickBooks remembers the sales price is 5 each, so we assume Alan gave us $50. When we click Save and Close, you can see that we now have 10 fewer in our inventory, and both the check and the sale receipt, the purchase and the sale, both record the unit of measure as BTL.